nothing beats our love for Filipino food. This week, our home cooks share their versions of classic vegetable dishes and pork humba only here on Potluck. Add a bit of crunch to your meal with these crispy shrimp fritters. Get to know Beverly Butuan's family recipe as she shares how to do her grandmother's Relyenong Repolyo.
Thank you.
now, let's taste the mouth-watering flavors of the North with this famous Ilocano dish, Inabraw.
Hello from Nueva Ecija. I am Israel Escosa and you are watching Potluck Season 2. Today, I will be sharing you my version of a classic Filipino vegetable soup dish recipe called Inabraw. Inabraw or dinengdeng in Ilocano is an authentic Filipino cuisine, usually composed of different kinds of locally homegrown vegetables boiled in fish bagoong. And it is best served with either grilled or fried fish. But before I start cooking, let's get to the ingredients. Now, let's cut and trim our vegetables. When cooking in a brow, make sure that you only get the freshest vegetables that is available. Or you can start planting in your backyard because most of the vegetables that we use is easy to plant and harvest. Remember that you don't have to cook fancy or complicated masterpieces, just good food from fresh ingredients. When cutting the papaya, cut it in eighths, peel and remove the seeds and thinly slice to make it cook faster. For the bamboo shoots, remove the outer layer skin to expose the edible part. Peel and cut it into long strips. Before adding to our inabraw, we need to pre-boil the bamboo shoots in salt water for 20 minutes and wash in cold running water to remove the bitter taste. Now, using your clean hands, separate the bones and the flakes of the smoked fish. Set aside and don't throw out the bones because we are going to make a stock that will be the base of our inabraw. Now that I have prepared all the ingredients, let's begin cooking. First, I'm going to make the stock. So in a clay pot, I'm adding 900 ml of top water. I'm adding the fish bone and the fish bagoong. This is around 6 tablespoons, but you can always adjust the taste. And a small size of ginger to take away or eliminate the fishy taste or smell. Don't worry, I'm going to strain all this stuff. Give it a good stir, cover, and I'm going to simmer this for about 20 to 30 minutes to extract all the flavor. While waiting for our stock, let's bread our fresh sardines. This is already washed and clean. Make sure to remove the gills and the innards. Let's coat our fish. When the fish are all coated, you can pop it in the fridge for like 30 minutes before frying, just to make sure that the breading won't fall off. Now that the stock is simmering for about half an hour, remove from the heat and using a strainer, strain all that unwanted stuff from the stock. Now, we have the base for our inabraw. Back into the clay pot, pour all the stock and we can now start adding our vegetables. To avoid overcooking our vegetables, add those with longer cooking times in first and put others in later. So first, I'm adding the papaya. And I'm going to boil this for about 3 minutes. After 3 minutes of boiling our papaya, we can now add our jute leaves and boil this for another 3 minutes before adding the pre-boiled bamboo shoots. Give it a good stir, and from there, we can now add our winged beans and the flakes of our smoked fish. You can always adjust the taste to your preference. And finally, I'm adding the rest of the ingredients. Cook it for 2 more minutes and turn off the heat before adding the clemency extract. Now, we have our classic Filipino vegetable soup dish in a brow. I'm going to set this aside, and to make this dish more enjoyable, let's crisp fry our fresh sardines. Heat the oil in a frying pan enough to deep fry our fish. Fry the fish in batches and don't overcrowd the pan. Putting too many fish in there at once affects the overall temperature of the oil, which can cause our fish to be greasy and saggy. I'm going to fry this until golden brown or until crispy but not burnt. Keep an eye on the temperature of the oil. It must be between 350 to 375 degrees Fahrenheit or 176 to 190 degrees Celsius. Want to try this simple but very accessible and healthy Inabraw with fried sardines? I'm pretty sure that your family will enjoy this recipe. Remember, a variety of veggies is the spice of life.
Enjoy this classic Filipino dish with a healthy twist. Let home cook Joana De Leon show you her easy sisig cabbage rolls recipe.
Hi everyone, this is Jai De Leon. I will be cooking sisig cabbage rolls.
Pork humba is delicious on its own, but it also tastes good as a pizza topping and a cuapao filling.
Hi, I'm Ruel Castillejos from Tacloban City, and today I'm going to be cooking pork humba. Pork humba is a traditional Visayan dish. It's somewhat like a sweetened version of adobo, but today I'm going to be sharing with you my take on the classic humba. So today we're going to be starting out with our meat. We're going to be working with roughly 500 grams of meat. And if you're going to choose a different type of meat, make sure that you get a good pork to fat ratio. Once you're happy with your slices, you're going to put it back in your bowl along with the other chunks of meat. And then you're going to add in the Worcestershire sauce. So next, we're going to add in a little milk. So we're just going to toss it well, make sure everything is well incorporated. And we're going to set it aside for now so that we can prepare our other ingredients. So I think we have a good amount of heat here already. And the key here is to drop your meat a few at a time. You want to maintain a good amount of heat so that everything will cook evenly and all that fat gets rendered. Our pork now has that nice golden brown color. You see all that oil extracted, and we're gonna use that later on. So we're gonna start off with the onions. Then we add in our garlic. We're now gonna add in our salt and pepper. And we're just gonna mix that. We're just gonna mix it all up. We're gonna let all that flavor from our onions and garlic incorporate with our pork. We're gonna add in our pineapple juice. Our soda and a little bit of water. Now, using pineapple juice and soda is gonna introduce that tangy, that sour, that sweet, all those wonderful flavors into your pork humba. And once you get a good boil, you're gonna reduce the heat, let it simmer for around 30 minutes, and we're just gonna leave this covered. Keep on stirring it from time to time to make sure nothing gets burned down to the pan. And we're now ready to add in our special ingredient, the kalamay. So it's important to have a little liquid to help your kalamay dissolve. So we're gonna check back on our pork humba, and now it's looking a little good. So we're now ready to add in our remaining ingredients, our peppercorns, star anise, banana blossoms, and our black beans. So in this case, I just want a little sauce because I'm gonna be using the excess sauce for our other pork humba variations. So I'm adding in about 50 ml of soda. So it's important to add your liquid just a little at a time. You form a glaze and then you deglaze your pan to your liking. We're gonna give this a final cook, maybe around 3 to 5 minutes. We're just gonna cover this. At this point, we'll already have added all the ingredients. We're just giving it a final cook, final whirl, and there. So I'm gonna transfer my dough to a pizza peel. I'm gonna lightly flour so that nothing sticks. So I'm good with this, and I'm just gonna top it off with the oil that we rendered from our humba earlier. Just give it a nice drizzle. Just gonna add just a little more flour, and we're ready to launch. Again, make sure to turn regularly. You don't want anything burning up. The final dish that I'm gonna be showing you today is the cuapao. It's simply steamed buns with your humba filling. So what I did was I used the same dough that I made to use my pizza. I just flattened it out, cut small circles using a glass, and then put it in the steamer, and now we have my little cute steamed buns. So here's how simple it is. Get your bun, get your humba. So at this point, you're basically just making a sort of a sandwich. And we're just gonna top this off with a few nuts. This is also the roasted nuts, the same that we used for our original pork humba. And there you have it, pork humba cuapao. So that's it, those are the three ways for you to enjoy your pork humba. We have pork humba with rice, pork humba pizza, and pork humba cuapao. That's it. Thank you for watching and have a great day.
Whether it be healthy or savory, everyone enjoys good Filipino fare. Upgrade your home cooking with these delicious recipes only here on Potluck.